Welcome to the star in you. It's yours truly, Junis. Please subscribe, like the page, and share with others. Hope all y'all blessed out there and doing your best out there. For real, for real. Huh, so much has transpired lately in the entertainment world, especially dealing with hip-hop, of course. So today we're gonna talk about Drake, Pusha T, and Kanye West in the number 6. And remember, when it comes to astrology and numerology, whether it's hip-hop, entertainment, or real life, these numbers do have an influence on the people revolved around it. So we're gonna get into that today. So sit back, relax, enjoy the show, and let the knowledge seep in. Let's go. So you can see the 6, it's always about lust and love. That's the negative aspect. And people born to 6, you know, sometimes they tend to make the poor choices and go through a couple of mates, you know, in their lifetime until they get to the right one. But they always have that dedication, they always believe in love in the long run. But, you know, that love aspect of Drake, you know, that's something that he talks about all too well throughout his songs, right? But he also talks about the lust as well, and you see that confusion aspect. And, you know, throughout history, there's been episodes and cases where people in the past, rappers, Drake, you know, has bumped into their exes, and, you know, did a little thing here and there, you know, which caused some kind of conflict. So you see that 6 aspect and that confusion there. But also you see that 6 causing the conflict and beef between him and Pusha T, making everything explode. Because, you know, he talked about Pusha T's significant other. And it's kind of interesting because Pusha T, he's a Taurus. And, you know, although Drake is born in 24 and he's ruled by Taurus with that number, but I guess it really took a real bull, you know, to squash the scorpion.
Okay.
And, you know, I'm not just saying that to be funny, but there is this weird conflict always between Scorpios and Taurus. And I always say that in my other videos. And you can see this with Drake and Meek Mill. But also you can see it with Drake and Chris Brown. But then you could also see with Diddy and Craig Mack. And there was also episodes with Diddy and Biggie trying to separate. And you know, Biggie's born right off that cuss. He's born on the 21st. Some would say that's Gemini, some would say that's Taurus. But I feel like it's more Gemini. You see, there's a conflict there between Scorpios and Taurus. Yes, they're in opposition of each other, and with oppositions, you know, with those signs, you know, they tend to have a little conflict here and there. But in the long run, you know, they tend to like each other and have a lot of love for each other. But for some reason, when it comes to Taurus and Scorpio, though, it don't always work out like that. It's not always the case, you know. And if they do get back together, it's always awkward. And you can see that because of that 6 dynamic that separates them with the opposition, and that 6 being ruled by Taurus, which is more in favor of the Taurus sign. So because of that, there's a conflict with Scorpios. And also, you're going to see there's going to be a jealousy aspect between the two signs. Being that Taurus, sometimes they tend to go with their talents most of the time with the hard and apply the hard work. Whereas Scorpios, in many ways, though they could be talented, they do focus on the money a lot and forget about their talent. So because of that, there could be a jealousy aspect is there. But also, you got to realize with the number 6, although it's ruled by the planet of love, you know, Venus, you know, it also has a vindictive nature to it as well. Because obviously, you know, the opposite of love is hate. So you can see with people born at Taurus, people who are Taurus, you know, they can be very reckless with their mouths. And you can see that Pusha T track, you know, he really went in, and a lot of people talked about certain things that he said was too touchy. But he goes to see the star from Star and Buck Wild, you know, that episode he did on Hot 97, he said certain things about Aaliyah, and people got really offended by that. But you can see the, you know, DJ Academics and other people who are Taurus, you know, they could really take it there when they get really upset and there's no hold bars, you know what I'm saying? And even they could even get physical. No offense to Chris Brown, but it could get like that because, like, when he stir up the bull, you know, they have a lot of love. When they feel betrayed or they feel like they're not liked, then they could just strike. Not saying, you know, people born to 6 could be physical, but, you know, if they betray them or they're disloyal to them, they could get vindictive and they'll show their vindiction in many ways, you know what I'm saying? But you could also see this vindictive nature, you know, between Meek Mill and Drake, you know, with Meek Mill exposing Drake of having ghostwriters. It kind of came out of nowhere, left field, because they were working together with that song Rico. So it was like, oh wow, Drake got a ghostwriter, so you saw that confusion. And you know, both of them being born with that 6, so you see how that 6 kind of interplayed. Drake come back to back, and it was a hit, success, thinking that Meek Mill was going to come back. So you see that luck kick in, but still though, it tarnished Drake's image a little bit, as you can see, you know, as a lyricist. But you know, to put ice in the cake, you know, Pusha T come with that track, The Story of Adon, you know, exposing his kid. You know, you can see that lust and confusion there as well, with between the lust and the love. Because, you know, Drake had a child with a woman that was in the adult entertainment business. You know, and even though that Duppy freestyle was really hot and a lot of people thought it was a rap after that and it was over, boom, that confusion kicked in as well. It wasn't, you know. Pusha T came off that track and it was pretty much in a way over Drake as where he stands at, you know what I'm saying? Not over, obviously, people still gonna rock with Drake where he's at because of all the hard work he put in, but still though, you know what I mean with the imagery at this point.